Okay, so welcome to this 33rd lecture of 7th week. You remember in the before this we talked about potential appraisal and how potential appraisal can be used to identify leaders for the future, right? So after discussing about potential appraisal, what we are going to discuss is that how and why we are going to link performance management with the reward system. If you remember in the beginning when we were talking about the objectives of the performance management or objectives of the performance appraisal particularly, and we discussed that there could be two different kind of objectives of performance appraisal system. One is developmental, the other one is administrative, right? So developmental and administrative are the two major objectives which are used to see that people are developed and also see that there are certain administrative decisions are taken based on the performance of the employees. Now, in this section and the next section, that is the next lecture, we are going to discuss about first what is the reward system, that how we can make use of an effective reward system to see that those employees who are performing well are motivated to perform at a higher level. And we will also see that how performance is linked with the reward and what are the practices that companies adopt in order to ensure that performance link reward system is going to be effective for higher performance of the individual. Now, when we are going to talk about reward system as such, then we have to understand that why we are going to link performance with the reward. See, when an individual is working in an organization, he anticipates certain things, okay. And the most important anticipation is the reward. It means that you are going to reward him in some way for what he is doing. In fact, if you look at the basic definition of reward, is that is that you are going to adequately compensate an individual for the work that he is doing, right? So we have to see that when you are going to adequately compensate an individual, so an individual for the work, it means that you are talking about the compensation system, okay. But here we are not going to talk about compensation as a system as such, because compensation is given for the work that you do, right? But here we are going to talk about another aspect of compensation system, that is reward, which is given to employees because his performance is better than others, okay. And then companies use a different kind of reward mechanism to motivate employees for higher performance. Now we have to discuss about the reward system and other issues related to the reward. Right. So, what is a reward? That is defined as it is defined, it is that it is the benefit which is given to the employees for better performance, right. So, a person is being rewarded if he is performing well, right. Now, the level of reward might vary depending upon the level of the performance, okay. Now, another objective that is going to be fulfilled by this is that it also motivates employees to perform at higher level, right. And then we have to see whether there is really a good relationship between motivation and performance, which is mediated by what you call the reward. So, is it correct to say that a person would be motivated to perform better provided he gets suitable reward, right. So, these are some of the questions that we need to look at. And similarly, we have to see that how this reward is managed by the organization. Right. Whether this reward is adequate, whether people are happy with the kind of reward that they are getting, right? Whether it's fulfilling their needs and expectations, whether it is really able to motivate people for better performance or not. Okay. So when we are talking about reward management, there are various issues that we need to look at it. Because when you are going to develop a reward system, okay, which is definitely a part of the compensation system, okay. Because if you look at the compensation system, it has two levels. One is that you are going to pay him for what he does, but in addition to pay, if you are going to give certain benefits to the employees in the form of reward, then it is in addition to what you call the pay and the perks that he gets, right. And then companies are trying to link these kind of reward with the performance, and they use different kind of mechanism for performing individuals. So, those who are performing better, they might get different kind of rewards compared to those who are not performing better. So, they also try to discriminate people based on the reward system. So, individuals who are performing at a higher level, they might get a better performance, And sometimes it might motivate others to perform well, but sometimes it also demoralizes others, and they think that the other person is getting a higher reward, a better compensation because of his performance. But since he is not capable, he is not able to perform at that level, he is not being rewarded suitably, right? So there could be a lot of issues related with the reward management that we wish to discuss further. Now, when we are talking about reward management or the compensation, as I told you that it has two components. One is your pay and salary, and other is benefits, which basically combines each other, and then it is what we call the total compensation package, right? Now, out of this total compensation package, reward is a part of the benefit, because reward is given for something that you do in addition to your regular job, which is defined by your job description, okay? And there could be certain standard performance criteria against which your performance is measured, and then you are being rewarded appropriately. So there could be different kind of system for rewarding, okay? So what we are going to discuss now is what are the different kind of reward system and how it works. Now, if you look at this reward system, there are two kind of reward system. One is traditional approach, one is contingent approach. Traditional approach means that you are going to reward people based on what they do, that is basically based on what you call the job description of the individual, right? So you look at the job description, you evaluate his job, try to find out the worth of a job, and then you try to reward him, or you are going to compensate him, right? But if you look at that contingent approach is different compared to traditional approach, is that here the reward is contingent upon the performance, okay? So that discriminates between people who are performing better than others, right? And if you look at this contingent approach, you will find two kind of things. One, that is the traditional culture, that how the performance is being linked with the reward, right? For example, many companies follow the system of piece rate, where you decide about what would be the rate per piece that is produced by the employees. That is, if suppose you have identified that, okay, 10 rupees per piece would be given to an employee, and then you see that how many pieces he has produced. So the number of pieces is multiplied by the rate per piece, and that is going to be his reward. So traditionally we follow these kind of systems where you are being paid based upon what you perform. It means you follow a system, and many departments in an organization could go for it. For example, production department. Similarly, another example that is given here is a sales people, and the commission is fixed depending upon how much revenue they are able to generate, how many sales they are going to close, right? Similarly, that is at the individual level. Now, at the group level, you also provide incentives for improving quality, efficiency, quality, and other kind of things. So, these are the traditional parameters that could be used for evaluating performance and then rewarding employees, or linking performance with the reward. Now, there are some other progressive, you can say, systems that have been developed at a later stage, where you expect employees to get better engaged and committed to organization and perform well, right? So this is what we know as involvement culture. What actually happens in an involvement culture is that you try to see that, depending upon the level of engagement and commitment, okay, whatever profit is made by the individual or the organization, you are going to reward him. Okay? Some examples that are given here, we will discuss that in detail at a later stage, like profit sharing. So for example, if an organization is making a profit of certain amount, so that particular amount is shared between the employers and the employees, right? Similarly, if you look at a skill based pay, this is that if you are going to get additional skills, if you have got an additional qualification or experience or skill, then that is to be compensated. So this actually motivates people to perform well, right? And then employers expect better engagement and commitment from the employees, because they think that if they are going to share their profit, it would lead to higher involvement of the employees, okay? So now what we are going to discuss in detail is these two kind of approaches, that is traditional approach and contingent approach. Traditional approach follows the basic principles that you are going to be compensated for your performance, and that depends upon what you call job description, right? So and the second one is that you, it is not only dependent on your job description, but you also say that if a person is going to perform better and more than that, then you are going to have salary differentials, right? Now it could be understood like this one. Say this one. See, traditional approach, what happens in this example is that you are going to reward an employee based upon the job description, right? So this is a range of scales or pay scales that you say in an organization, okay? Start, this is for the manager's level, starting with E3 up to E9, and you can see that there is a progression, salary progression, depending upon the position, okay? For example, if you see that from officers to when you move to assistant manager level, okay, there is a slight increase. As you move up to the hierarchy, become a deputy manager, a manager, or senior manager, or you reach to the executive director level, what happens? There is a progression in your salary, okay, and then you also get an annual increment. So, what I am trying to tell you is that when you are talking about this traditional approach, that how does it work? Let us see this one. So, in traditional approach, basically what happens that you talk about compensation, okay, and this compensation is based upon job description, right. What you follow or do is that in order to develop a grade, what you call this job grades, okay, you are going to follow certain mechanism, that is you see that these job grades which you have, say for example, at different levels, starting with say E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, suppose there are 5 different job grades. So, the salary progresses like this one, okay, it from what you call low to high, okay. So, the compensation structure that is decided based on job description takes care of 2 factors, that is that your internal equity external equity and the third one is individual equity. Okay. So, when we are talking about internal equity, it means that you try to ensure that the person is compensated based upon his performance, and then how you decide it, the data comes from job description. So, in order to maintain internal equity, you, what you do, you go for job evaluation, right. For external equity, you try to have parity with other organizations and similar jobs in different organizations, okay. And individual equity, where you try to look at the output input of the individual, the what is the productivity and whether the person is satisfied with the productivity of his performance or not. So, we follow 3 different methods, that is you look at the output input ratio of the individual, you also try to ensure that there is a external parity, it means similar jobs in other organizations are paid at the similar level, and then you also go for internal equity, that is you try to maintain some kind of standards to ensure that depending upon the contribution that the job makes to the organization, the salary is given. So, job evaluation is basically a process of identifying the worth of a job, and based on this worth you are paid. So, here when you are saying that this, it means that the worth is something like this, it starts with low to high worth, it means you can say that the job that E5 has is highest paid worth, and that is why you will find it is having the highest salary or reward, whatever you say, right. So this is the most traditional approach that is adopted by the organization. But in this case, what happens that you develop a salary structure, a compensation structure, but you forget about reinforcing those who are performing well at different levels. Even if they are performing well, the salary does not change, right? And that is why it is known as a traditional system, right, of identifying pay and reward. Okay. So now the companies have understood that this kind of traditional system is not going to be very, very effective. Okay. At the base level it might work, but if people are performing better or at a higher level and if they are not being rewarded, then it might have certain repercussions for the organizations. Okay. They will not be able to manage their talent, employee turnover rate would be very high, people would leave for higher paying jobs, right. So all kind of problems might happen, and that is why most of the companies move from these traditional systems to what you call a contingency based pay, right. So you are moving from a traditional based system to what you know as contingency based pay, right. And this contingency based pay is much better because it does not only take care of your job description, which defines your performance standards, and then you are compensated. But if you are performing better, then it also take care of high performance and it links it with the reward, so that you are adequately compensated, right. So if you look at this traditional approach that I have just discussed, that how salary progression is made from E3 to E9, okay, this is the most traditional approach. And then this existing pay scale that has been shown here is based on job description, and then you go for maintaining internal external equity, and then also based upon the output of the individual, right. So this is what we call the traditional approach. Now from traditional approach we are moving to what you call contingency based pay. Basically this is what is related to performance. Okay. It means that in addition to whatever salary you are getting, okay, you are being paid for better performance, right. The idea for paying more for higher performance is that it is going to motivate you to continue to perform at a higher level or also sustain at that particular level, right. Now when we say that whether pay is a motivator or not, there could be different theories. Okay. Some theories try to explain that pay motivates employees, while some theories say suggest that pay does not motivate employees. But my suggestion here is that pay does motivate employees to perform better. Okay. And also there are certain consequences associated with, because like he will be motivated, better engaged, there will be higher commitment, he will be highly satisfied with the job, provided he understands the value of reward, okay, that is being given to him. So there are a lot of motivational theories are there. Now one theory which is very, very important here is this valence theory, which talks about expectancy theory, which talks about that whether the person would be motivated to perform well or not depends upon three factors, right. So we are using this Room's expectancy theory to explain whether employee would be motivated to perform well and how it is going to be linked with the reward. Now if you look at this formula of motivation, it talks about three indicators, that is expectancy, instrumentality and valence. Now if you look at the definitions that is given for expectancy, instrumentality and valence, they are all multiplied with each other. So what is the expectancy, right? For example, if I am performing at a higher level, then I expect better results, right? And if there is a better result, then it must be linked with higher reward. So the idea here is that you need to establish between a relationship between the efforts that you put in, and if this effort is resulting in higher performance or not. So basically at the first level we expect a relationship, a positive relationship between effort and performance, with the assumption that higher efforts would result in higher performance, right. Now at the first level we expect good performance, right, and for that we are putting in lot of efforts, right. Suppose you are going to put lot of effort in doing this course, then you expect better grades. So that is reflected in your performance, right? And suppose you are doing very well and then you are putting lot of effort and then you expect higher performance, right? And higher performance could be linked with your grades, that could be a reward, right? Now at the second stage, what happens? Once you have been able to establish a positive relationship, it's a linear relationship, because if effort moves on, the performance will also improve. Okay, so you can expect a linear relationship between effort and performance at the first level. Now moving to the second level, what happens? That is what we call instrumentality. What is instrumentality? Okay, here you try to establish a link between performance and reward. Okay, so there are three variables now: effort first, performance second, and reward three. So at the first level, we try to examine the relationship between the effort and the performance, and we try to see that there is a positive relationship. At the second level, we try to examine the relationship between performance and reward. Okay, so now there are three things: effort, performance, and reward. Right? Effort performance leads to expectancy. Performance reward is instrumental. It means that reward is instrumental on higher performance, right? So if you perform well, you would get better reward, right? Now third factor, which is very very important, is valence. Valence is basically related to attraction, how attractive or valuable the reward is for the individual, right? Though we are trying to establish a linear relationship between effort, performance, and reward, we also need to see that the reward that is being given to the employees is fulfilling their needs and expectations. He finds it valuable. Okay, if he finds that the reward is not significant and it does not meet their needs and expectations, then what happens? He will not find it very very valuable, and then if you look at the cycle, then he will stop making efforts, because he thinks that even if he is making effort and it is leading to higher performance, it does not lead to suitable rewards. So the companies have to follow this model to ensure that whatever reward they are giving for higher performance is acceptable to the employees, in a sense that it is meeting their needs and expectations. If it is not meeting their needs and expectations, then this kind of reward system is not going to be appropriate for the employees. Now there are certain suggestions that could be made to ensure that these reward system are going to be made useful for the employees. Okay, it means that you have to clearly define and measure performance. It means that you should have very clear definition of what the performance is that you are expecting, and what are the performance standards against which you are going to reward people. So first to define your and measure your performance standards and level, and then you link it with the reward, right? And make sure that only you are giving those rewards which are available, which can be offered by the organization. You don't promise something, give something which you cannot give at a later stage. So don't promise anything which cannot be given. So make sure that whatever rewards are available within the system is provided. Okay, and you also ensure that you are not going to discriminate if organization is making a profit. Okay, so try to include everyone in this kind of system and make sure that everybody is being rewarded. Okay, depending upon their level of performance, or if it is an organization wide reward, then everybody is eligible depending upon his level in the organization. And make sure that it is visible. It means that it is significant. Okay, and it is really motivating employees for higher performance. Okay, and another issue that we have already talked about, it should be contingent. Contingent in the sense it should be based on the performance only, okay, right? And that is why we say that make rewards contingent. Contingent in the sense that reward must be linked with the performance level or the standards. Okay, another issue that has been identified when we are going to have any kind of reward mechanism or administration of reward is that when you are going to provide the reward. So the idea here is that if you are going to provide it timely and appropriate reward is given, that it is going to be more effective to motivate people. But if you are going to provide it at a later stage, then the person would not be in a position to link the reward with the performance, because he has done something at previous date, and then later on you are going to reward him. So he would not be able to establish a clear link between the reward and performance. Okay. Similarly, if the person is not able to perform well, okay, it should be reversible. It means that you can also withdraw the reward. It's not only giving the reward, but if the performance level is not achieved by the individual, make sure that these performance are withdrawn from the individual. Okay. And the thing that is very, very important is that it is not only financial rewards which are going to help people, especially at the higher level. It has been found that if you are going to provide more non-financial rewards, right, then it is more effective, like status, recognition, challenge. So these kind of things are more important to the individual at a higher level than financial rewards, right? So when you are going to have some kind of reward system, and if you are going to take care of this, then you are increasing the valence of the reward. That is the third point that I have been talking about. So when you are going to multiply expectancy with instrumentality and valence, and if you are going to have a reward system which follows these guidelines, then the value of valence will be high, and then it would be in a better position to motivate employees. Yeah. So when we are talking about different kind of rewards, there could be two type of rewards. Okay, as I told you, intrinsic reward and extrinsic reward. Extrinsic reward means which could be in the form of, say, money, promotion, fringe benefits. Okay, it is external to the job and come from outside sources, especially that is given by the top management, right? Then coming to the intrinsic reward. Intrinsic reward, it means that when you are doing a job and you feel satisfied that yes, I have done something that is worthwhile. Okay. So you feel satisfied, you find that yes, it is something that you have done really good, which has contributed to your performance in the organizational performance, and where you have the idea that okay, you have made a significant contribution to the job and the performance, right? So these intrinsic rewards could be based on satisfaction from the job, okay, which is internal in nature, okay, and then you can follow certain mechanism like giving him more responsibility, like enriching the job, okay, more freedom, right, giving him shorter work weeks, or moving the individual to different kind of jobs so that he can share different kind of responsibilities, okay, or moving to flexi time, so let him decide at what point of time he is going to work. Okay. So these kind of actually mechanism is used to ensure that those who are significantly contributing towards the job and performance and are not motivated by external factors. Okay. So basically you need to identify what kind of reward people are looking forward to. If people are looking for external rewards, then go for it. If people are looking for internal rewards, so go for these kind of things. So if you want to increase the valence, you need to ensure this valence is coming from where. Okay. And it could vary from individual to individual. In some cases people would be lured or attracted by intrinsic rewards. Okay. And that would have more value for them, so they might find it more valuable. In some cases, people are looking forward to status, recognition, and challenge, right? So you need to internally satisfy them and make sure that these kind of intrinsic satisfaction is available, which is going to be more valuable for them, right? And similarly, you can identify or classify them into financial and non-financial rewards. Okay. So extrinsic is basically financial, and intrinsic is non-financial. So that is another way to categorize rewards, right? So financial rewards include wages or higher wages, more bonus or profit sharing, which is extrinsic, which is visible in the form of money, and non-financial like giving them different kind of leaves, benefits and facilities. So they are part of fringe benefits, basically like giving them a pension or paid vacations, or they are going on leave, okay, with full salary. So these kind of things basically does not increase their financial status, okay, but they feel more happy and satisfied, okay. And it has been found that non-financial rewards make life as well as job more attractive compared to financial incentives, okay, because financial intrinsics, non-financial rewards lead to more intrinsic satisfaction, and financial rewards lead to more extrinsic satisfaction. So when we are talking about valence, that is what I have been talking about, and basically we have been looking into this relationship of effort, performance and reward, and we try to say that if a person is putting in higher effort, okay, and if this is the level of performance, is a linear relationship. Now, if you add this side reward, so whether it means that higher effort, more better performance and higher reward, right? Now the question is that this reward, how it is valued by the people in the organization, okay? It depends upon the valence. Now there could be lot of variations when we are talking about the valence, okay? And it depends, as I told you, it depends upon intrinsic factors and extrinsic factors. Extrinsic is financial in nature, so you go for financial rewards, and this is non financial. Now you have to identify what is going to provide valence, okay? Because when we are talking about valence, which is coming from the form of reward, so it could be you can expect this kind of relationship only when the reward is found valuable. If it is not found valuable, then you cannot expect a linear relationship between effort, performance and reward, okay? Now moving to the next part, that is whether it is going to be based on performance or whether it is going to be based on membership, right? And that is what basically differentiate between the traditional and non-traditional reward system, okay? So when we are talking about merit based pay, it is performance, and when we are talking about structured wages or salaries, it depends upon it is related to what you call the membership based reward. For example, you are being compensated for cost of living, okay, organization sharing profit with everybody, okay, you are being paid for your seniority and the time that you are going to invest in an organization, or depending upon your rank. So these are related with membership base. So depending upon your level in the hierarchy, there is a prefixed structure of compensation which will be paid to you. But it has nothing to do with your performance, okay? It is expected that you are going to performance at the standard level, right? But when we are going to talk about performance based pay, we are talking about, yes, whether it is piece rate or any other method or sales commission or anything, any kind of bonus or incentives that is provided, it is basically dependent upon higher performance, right? So we have to see that what is going to motivate employees, okay? So membership based reward does not motivate employees more, right? You will continue to do your performance at the standard level, but when you are going for performance based rewards, definitely it is going to motivate people, because you are going to provide some kind of extra incentives and rewards to the employees in addition to what is the compensation in a structured format that is given to the individual, right? Now it could be in the form of tangible or intangible rewards, like whether you are going to provide cash benefits, right, or whether you are going to provide them non cash benefits. So basically we have to say that the benefits, the additional benefits which is being given for higher performance, is in the form of cash or non cash, or whether it is tangible or what you call non tangible. So when we are going to talk about tangible, which can be seen, which is concrete in nature, like there is a merit pay, cost of living expenses, right, increase in the basic pay, right? So if these kind of rewards are given, then it is tangible. Intangible, when you are going for status, recognition, challenge, higher opportunities, right? So that is more effective to motivate employees, right? So recognition and reward has to be linked, but you have to see that whether it is really people are looking forward to these kind of things or not. It also depends upon the need strength of the people, at what level they are, okay? People at the lower level of their need strength or motivation are looking forward to more tangible returns compared to those who are at the higher level, okay? If you have a higher motivation need strength or higher level of need strength, right, then you look for reward based on your recognition, right? It could be challenging jobs, more self esteem, better recognition for what you do, right, compared to going for tangible rewards. So it also another important factor that we need to identify, that what is the need strength of the individual, right? So if you are at the lower level of the needed strength, you are looking for more tangible returns compared to being at a higher level where you look forward to more intangible returns, right? Now, if when we are looking about reward and what kind of reward people are looking forward to is like here some classifications have been made that what is valued as a reward by the employees, and there are certain categories that have been given here like nesters. Okay, so they look for opportunities, those who want to travel or want to be away from home, right? So they would like to have more flexible schedules. So if you are this you are in this category, then you want to spend money on traveling or have a flexible schedule so that you can satisfy this kind of need. Then those who are looking for tangible rewards, they are bottom liners because they are looking for cash rewards, bonus and these kind of things. Freedom earners, it means that they want more flexibility. Okay, so they want to have freedom in how what they achieve, you decide, but how they are going to achieve it, they are going to decide it. So they are looking for more autonomy and freedom in their activities, though they are concerned with the performance, but they want to decide how they are going to do it and what they are going to do it. Now the praise covers basically when you move at the higher levels, right? It means that they want to be acknowledged for their performance. Okay, so it could be in form of appreciation, recognition, or whatever it is, right? Then upward movers. Okay, so these kind of employees would be satisfied if they are getting some kind of status. They are moving up in the organization, okay, and they are getting better opportunities. Okay, so different kind of categories have been identified depending upon what kind of reward is going to be valuable. Again, it is related to valence. The idea is that you have to see that what you are looking forward to, some form of intangible rewards or some form of tangible rewards. So it depends upon what you are looking forward to, because that is going to be more valuable, which increases your attraction. That is the valence, right? And that is how when we are going to multiply this with the performance and effort, we need to ensure that it is going to motivate. Because if you are looking forward to something as a reward you are not getting, then probably it is not going to motivate you to put in more effort leading to higher performance, right? So we need to be very, very careful when we are going to administer a reward, see what kind of reward is going to be more successful for the employees, right? So what we have discussed there is basically is the reward mechanism, okay, that is whether you are going for traditional or non-traditional methods, right? So now the total reward is include your basic pay, salary, other things, and also non-financial performance, right? So it, the first part is transactional. It means that you are given it for what you do. Okay, so that is basically what you call compensation and benefits, right? The relational rewards is something different, which is non-financial in nature, which is going to be more attractive to the individual. Okay, it could lead like better job opportunities, better learning experiences, recognition, achievement and growth. So when we are looking at the reward mechanism as such, we need to look at both, okay, the transactional part and the relational part, because both of them are going to be part of the total compensation package, right? Now when you the managers are going to do it, they have to see that what they are interested in basically. So you have to see that they need to be recognized for what they do or what they contribute. How you are going to recognize them? Either using a financial rewards or non-financial rewards, right? So you have to decide about that, okay, what kind of reward is going to be more suitable and is going to help employees to perform better, right? So you have to adopt a different kind of approach. The one approach that is discussed here is GRAB. Back, it means that you identify what are the rewards which is going to be valuable to the employees and you give them. Or we also follow this cafeteria approach. You decide, okay, this is the total, this is the total value of the reward. Now you decide what kind of reward you are looking forward to, right? And then let the individual decide or the employee decide what kind of reward is going to be more valuable for him, and based on that you decide what is to be given to them, okay, and then it is going to be more effective in motivating the people, right? So now if you look at this, it is very, very important that you have a good reward system in place depending upon what employees want, what employees value, right? okay, that is very, very important, whether you are going to pay them financial rewards or non-financial rewards, right. Irrespective of that, whether it is going to be intrinsically satisfied or extrinsically satisfied. So, you have to spend time on designing a very important system, that is what we call it a reward system, and make sure that it is leading to higher performance. So, you design your compensation structure in such a way and provide appropriate reward so that people are happy and satisfied, okay, and it is fair and equitable as well, right, because we talked about equity, that is very, very important, internal, external and individual equity when you are going for internal pricing mechanism, right. So, make sure that you have an appropriate reward system which is going to motivate employees for higher performance, right. So, whether you are giving monetary or non-monetary, it is up to you, but the most important factor is that you need to recognize people for better performance. How you are going to recognize them? Whether you are using a financial compensation or non-financial compensation, you decide about it, but make sure that they are being recognized for higher performance or better performance. Thank you very much.